Hey, it's Clay Trader, and this will be a video chart on ticker symbol DXTR. We will take a look at the 30-minute time frame. Real quick, what do I mean by 30-minute in case maybe you're new to charts? Instead of each one of these candlesticks here representing one day's worth of price action, which is what you would normally see, each one represents 30 minutes. So while this here may look like a few weeks worth of time, it's actually just the past couple of days broken down into 30-minute time slices. I like you this time frame. I think it does a good job of telling the quote-unquote story of the price. And then just makes mapping out levels of support and resistance a bit easier to see. Did this analysis on Friday, so that's where the green line annotation is coming from. And just quickly want to do an update here, as now that we have more data, there's been a level, update's probably not the right word, more so kind of confirmation of a point. And that is where the sellers seem to really be hanging out at. So first, just a quick little recap. Key area of support is down here at this point on the chart, which is valued at the 27 cent mark. If you're curious, you know, why this 27 cent mark down here is so important, then you can just go back and watch one of the videos from the archive, but I'm not going to beat that dead horse or anything like that. The main thing that I want to focus on is this newer area of resistance. Not really new, but just, you know, it was certainly confirmed as an area of resistance where the sellers are definitely hanging out at. Now, as far as areas of resistance are concerned, definitely some hanging out there right at the 35 cent mark. I believe I talked about that in passing in Friday's video. But the reason I'm not using the word confirmation is because, you know, today, early morning, price made a nice move to the upside, and surprise, surprise, right around here, the same area of 35 cents, the bulls once again struggled, and that's where the price, you know, ultimately did get rejected back down, and, you know, the price fell. So don't get me wrong, I'm not saying 35 cents is impossible to break through or anything like that. Not saying that at all. All I'm saying is that according to the story of the chart that it's telling us, apparently the bulls are really going to have to bring their A game if they're going to be able to fight through this, area of the chart up here at 35 cents. So that is definitely, key level of resistance going, into the remainder of the week. All in all, though, as long as the price keeps on building those higher bases, then eventually 35 cents will be taken care of. But that's definitely, kind of short-term resistance to keep an eye on for the week. So all in all, good week, or I should say good start to the week. Can you tell that tomorrow's 4th of July? And it's kind of throwing me off here. But yeah, on that note, friendly reminder, tomorrow is 4th of July and the markets are closed. So it'll be interesting to see how the rest of this week all unfolds. One of the biggest questions that I get is, hey, Clay, how do you find the stocks that you trade? So what I've done is put together a free resource guide where I talk about the tools that I use to locate stocks that I find interesting and think may have potential. So if that sounds like something that could add value to you as a trader, then click on the image that is up on the screen right now, and I will email you the guide. The guide itself is very short and to the point, and best part, it's completely free. Thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any questions.